da ja loose, oh la la, da. There it is. Yeah, he was sure giving me the once over. His eyes were glued to my boobs, just like the first time we encountered each other. He smiled that big dumb smile of his and came on over the jukebox. Said he had to tell me how much he just loved my singing, that I sounded just like Edie Gourmet. He invited me to join him for a drink, which I did. Let me see now. Bourbon and water, wasn't it, Sissy? Well, that one led to another and another, and then he began to pour out the woeful tale of the wife he left behind. The ex-queen of the Dixie Rotary from McAuley, Texas, who had boobs the size of watermelons. Oh, he really thought she was something. Not so since their high school days, when they used to get together before they had that hanky-panky in the old graveyard. Oh, he was crazy over them watermelons of hers. They really won him over. They got married eventually and were living happily ever after. Until one day the watermelons just disappeared, went away. And so did... I'm sorry, Sissy. I went too far.
Good, stop now, for Christ's sake. I want to know where the hell the watermelons went.
Sissy, I told you not to marry him. I told you he didn't really love you.
Well, he did too. He worshipped me. He told you he loved me. He told me. I'll pay for him after pay for him.
Sissy, so sorry. Why didn't you tell us?
Oh, what the hell do you want me to do? Run in and rip open my dress and say, hey, everybody, Sissy's back and look, no more tits? I was too scared to say anything to anybody. Was the tea? I'll sleep with it again and never know. Oh, we love it so much. Oh, he loved me after. He was one hell of a lot of it all. Every night, two, three times we met buddies. After the operation, he dwindled down once a week. And then with the life out, there's his hand wanting to be tough for it. This wasn't bad. I cried it. So I knew one day he wouldn't want me no more. And that day came and he went. Did he make love to you? He wanted to. Begged and pleaded with me to go off somewhere with him. I considered it for revenge. Considered letting him have his way with me and then surprising him with my real identity. God, I would have given anything to see the look on his face.
Yes, I had a lot of damn things around. I'm all pinch and squeeze. I never gave a rat's ass for me. Hey,
I'm out here for calling the second! Guess what? The robot! This is our robot! This is our robot!
Myself all the rub on the last couple years, didn't I? It's a real tip at all. Good trend.
That's not funny.
What do you want me to do, cry? I cried enough. I cried for 3 goddamn years. I need me another bed.
You can leave any time you feel like it. Don't think you have to stay to the end on our account.
I can't leave without my cup.
Well, they'll be returning with it and Jimmy Dean. You know, it makes me sick to my stomach to see how people can be so cruel. Now what's so funny?
You! It makes me sick to my stomach to see how people can be so cruel.
Oh, I wonder what's taking me so long. This phone's out of order, just like everything else in this room.
Well, there ain't nothing wrong with the goddamn phone. He's gone.
Well, I can see that. Heavens, I'm not blind.
Then why do you think everybody else is?
I don't get your point.
Stop all the crap, Mona. He's run away. Flew the coop. He's gone.
He couldn't have run away. He doesn't even know what that means. He can't do anything without my help. I mean, he's just a poor, helpless child.
No, Mona, that's what you are. He's all grown up. You open up your damn eyes and see it.
No, his mind is...
The only thing wrong with his mind was that he couldn't make it up quick enough to get the hell out of here. Away from you and your crazy ideas about it. Well, he finally made it up on him.
He's gone. He couldn't make up his mind alone.
I helped him.
You?
I helped, damn it. I gave him every damn red cent I had in my purse to get him started. Someplace else, away from you.
No. No. Put ideas like that into the eye. Hello, Laura. You mean deceitful bitch! I'll kill you, Sam!
James Dean.
Holy shit!
Stella, all you had to do was egg though.
Little Jimmy Dean finds out his dad is really a lady.
Hey, you son of a bitch. Can I buy you a drink?
Listen, that storm's passed right on over us. Like we didn't even matter. Probably gone on to some town that don't even need it. Believing's such a funny thing, ain't it? Especially in what you believe in and don't even know you exist. All my life, I prayed to him. Believed in him.
It's the praying that did it.
Does this stuff really make things different?
Not one hell of a bitch.
Go on, take a sleep with him. God's not looking.
Sydney said it did. I tried to protect him. I even lied to God so he'd take him into heaven. Maybe that's the reason God's punished me. He's probably found out the truth about Sydney.
Well, looks like it's all over, darn it. Beer's gone and sandwiches is failing.
So sad.
Oh, for Christ's sake.
What are you sad?
All right, I'm sad. You happy now? Come on, gather your crap together and let's shove off before one of them gets the idea of starting in on me next.
What's the matter, Stella? You got something hidden away in your closet?
The only secret I've got is the combination to my safety deposit box.
Well, what you hurry then? Why don't you stay a day or two?
Oh, come on, what do you say? No. My world don't like it when I stay away for too long. You know, I think the bastard's scared I'm gonna meet somebody better. Penna, honey, you ready?
Hi, everybody. I had a real nice time, and I want to thank y'all for still liking me. No, I'm not very smart. Am I still glowing?
Just like a Texas sunrise.
Come on.
Bye, Stella. I'll see you in hell.
Oh, but well, we will get together soon, won't we?
Let's make it fast. Say 20 years.
Oh. Let's make it someplace cool next time, huh?
We could have it in my house. We got ourselves a new winter air conditioner, and by then the kids will be all grown up.
Honey, at the rate you're going to have 7 more to replace them with, too. Can you imagine anything more horrible?
Oh, Stella, you give up everything you have to just one of our kids, and you know it.
Well, me and Merle's got kids. Hundreds of them.
Oh, well.
Well, they're our kids. We got us a name for each one, too. Let's see now, there was Merle Jr., Freddie, Stella, Ann.
I don't have a real one.
Huh? Wouldn't have one in the house. Merle says the only way to have a baby is with beans and potatoes salad and a barbecue. Oh, he's such a card.
I feel sorry for you.
Well, who in the hell are you to feel sorry for me?
Anna Louise Johnson.
And who in the hell is that?
Somebody very important to me and my family. We may not have lots of money and fancy cars like you do, but we're happy with each other.
Happy? Well, hell, anybody can be happy. Look at me. I laugh all the time. Laugh my ass off at just about anything.
You're not happy.
I'm happy, goddammit! You know, I never could stand people who say they gotta go and then they never do.
Bye.
Mona, you'll lock up and turn out the lights before you leave. Sissy, I expect to see you here first thing in the morning, taking down these decorations. I'm going to stop on over at the cemetery before I go on home and have myself a little talk with Sydney. Mona, you'll be here in the morning, same time as usual?
I'll be here, Juanita.
It's nice to see you again, Juanita.
I hope you found what you were looking for, miss.
Well, looks like it's all over now, except for the end.
How's it end?
With just us, the same way it started, I guess.
I came by to say so long to Sissy.
She had a date over the graveyard with Rusty Teeth.
Tell her goodbye from them, will you?
Where are you going, Joe? Do you know?
Do you care?
I had to, Joe. Will you ever forgive me?
No.
Don't worry not about your car. There's a bus leaving from Big Spring about 9:30. He just borrowed it to get there in time to catch it, I'm sure.
Where's he going from there?
See where all the trains go. Hey, how about the McGuire sisters getting together for one final number?
Oh, hell, Sissy. I don't even think I know the words.
Oh, I know the words. Come on, you just move your mouth and pretend you do. Come on, Mona.
He's really gone.
Well, he told me to write you a letter to let you know where he is going.
I worry about him all the time.
He's going to be just fine, Mona.
But his mother, I have to worry.
I know.
Come on, Mona. Let's leave him for that. It's been so long. I don't know whether I'm on the right or the left.
You're on the right, and Joe was on the left. I was dead center.
Sissy, your center was never dead.
Now,